Welcome then to Marina Bay in a tough, bumpy street circuit that will test these drivers to their absolute limit. So sit back and enjoy the action here at the Singapore Grand Prix. We have a high risk of a safety car here today as the abundance of tight corners mixed with these wet conditions could put a few cars off into the barriers. 23 turns then, 13 to the left and 10 to the right, make up the 3.1-mile lap of Marina Bay. It's not going to be plain sailing for our drivers today, although with the sky falling as it is, perhaps sailing isn't too far from the truth. Anthony Davidson, could be a wet one today. Great to have you with us. What are your thoughts?
It is a touch damp, isn't it? Well, as a driver, there are three big things to worry about when racing in these kind of conditions. Standing water, tyre temperature and visibility. Judging distance to the cars around you is really tricky when you're driving through the vast amounts of spray that these wet weather Pirelli tyres kick up.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, and starting alongside in P2 is Sebastian Vettel. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Bottas, Daniel Ricciardo and Verstappen, Hülkenberg, Alonso, Magnussen and Roman Grosjean, Sainz, Perez, Esteban Ocon and Leclerc, Gasly, Van Dorn, Brendan Hartley and Lance Stroll, Ericsson and Sergei Sorokin rounds off the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
Thank you.
Great work. That's a new fastest lap for the race. Reduce the ERS deployment, please. We need to charge the battery. We're still on the right tyres for the time being. Okay, I think the track will be drying out quite soon. Mind you, don't burn out your tyres. We're a plus one lap of extra fuel. Fuel target plus one. Let's use some of this energy, increase the ERS deployment. It's not a perfect situation, but I don't think we have cause to move onto a different tyre yet. Battery charge is high. Let's increase ERS deployment to up the pace. Okay, we can take you this lap. check your MFD for a new strategy option. The gap to the car behind is 2.5 seconds. Go, go, go! Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. The stewards have now enabled DRS. DRS is now online. We're not going to be able to run in this engine mode much longer. We're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix two soon. Valtteri is in for his stop. Gap behind is 9.6 seconds. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. DRS is offline. The rear wing is down, so you can stay out while we work on a fix. We're leading our teammate by 8.1 seconds. There's four laps of fuel remaining. We have two laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap, final lap of the race. Less than a lap of fuel now, the tank is empty. Absolutely fantastic. It's a brilliant result. Well done.
So, another fantastic victory for the Silver Arrows. So, Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
I think a large part of the result comes down to temperament. They were able to keep their heads when everyone around them was losing theirs, and that's allowed them to get the best out of the car, to maximise the strategy, and to stay out of trouble.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Let's give it to Sergio Perez. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
That's it for today's Grand Prix. And from Ant and I, it's goodbye and see you again next time.